actually been doing a bit of DIY and a bit of yard work out in my garden. Last week, me and my fella actually tatted up a garden bench that I've had for a long time. It was looking a bit worse for wear, so sanded all the paint off it, off all the wood and the metal work. I repainted it. My fella even replaced some of the knackered wood on it as well. And it looks good as new, dead chuffed. But this weekend, it stays fine outside. Sort out this table that we're in the garden when I actually bought this house. Now it is looking a bit worse for wear. All the wood's a bit bored and bent on it, so we need to sort that out because it's a good table and I'm not chucking it out. But tonight, with a bit of talking, occasional hand sounds and movements, I'm going to go through a couple of my favourite books, like one of my previous videos, because I do a lot of reading. And while I'm at work, I do listen to a lot of audiobooks as well. I devour audiobooks at work. I've gone through loads since I've been working there. Gone through a lot of ones that I read a long time ago. But before I kick off, I just want to say thanks to everyone who's subscribed so far, making me smile. Thank you to everyone who's been leaving all those lovely comments as well. Now, there have been a few requests, and I'm going to try and get around to them as soon as I can. So, if you haven't done already, if you want to click the subscribe button, click on the notification bell and all, let you know when I've uploaded. And you can always, always leave me comments whenever you like. I'm always here. I'll go on to the first book. So this one is A Scanner Darkly by Philip K. Dick. It's possibly one of my all-time favourite writers. Not only that, but we actually share a birthday. It's December 16th, which I thought was pretty cool. Some of the psychosis that happens in it. This book's all about drugs, to be honest, but never been one for drugs myself. You shouldn't do drugs either, it's not good. But you do really get caught up in it. And it can make you feel a little uneasy as well. So much, you get swept up in them. And the film is quite an accurate portrayal of this book as well. And the special thing about the film really surreal look. Rotoscoping is an animation technique. And this was something that was originally developed by Max Fleischer, if I remember correctly. He's the guy that created the character Betty Boop. And in order to portray things like movement, they used to record actors dancing, for example, or walking, running, whatever. And then they used to animate over the top of that. And it was also something that was predominantly used by Walt Disney as well back in the day. And it gave the character animation a more lifelike look. But the entire film of A Scanner Darkly is rotoscoped. And it means that it gets really, really trippy, like the book. Person. If I remember correctly, he wrote in it this was his testament. Apparently this book is the reason why he shot John Lennon. And if you watch South Park, this book was mentioned in a particular episode where the boys write their own book, try and write something really offensive, and they do. I think it's that episode anyway, it's been a while since I've seen it. But they finally get to read Catcher in the Rye after Mr. Garrison, I think it was, said, you know, it's been knocked off the banned list and we can read it now, and they all thought that the book was pretty lame. Meanwhile, Butters reads it. As soon as he finishes it and puts it down, he sets out to kill John Lennon.
Kill John Lennon.
It's almost like a coming of age book, coming of age story. Cyberpunk as a genre. It's been one of my favourite sort of media genres for a very long time. A lot of my favourite films, books, games, anime are all pretty much out of the cyberpunk genre. The Altered Carbon TV series as well, which was on Netflix. The first series was just a little shy of amazing, in my opinion. And I'll tell you for why. Because they had to go and put a love story in it, didn't they? The books never really had that in it. Series rolled round, it kind of failed and was subsequently cancelled. The visuals, the costumes, all of that was amazing. But they just had to go and put a love story in it, didn't they? And that ruined it. Why we're not getting a third season. Honestly, this is the future we're talking about. I just think those outfits were so cool. I can't wait until I get my workshop sorted so I can start working on them properly. First season, the one where Joel Kinnaman played Takeshi Kovacs, and he had that mad sort of Hello Kitty rip-off backpack thing, which had like Hello Unicorn on it. That was my favourite character in the entire series, that backpack, because it stuck with him. He didn't care what it looked like, he needed something to carry his weapons around him. I just get to do a bit of soldering, and I love soldering. But I definitely recommend Alter Carbon if you do like sci-fi, futuristic, cyberpunk type, almost noir detective-ish. Interested. Maybe for a future video I could go through some of my favourite mangas. Some of the best things I have in my comic collection. What do you think? But for now I'm gonna love you and leave you. I hope you've enjoyed my little ramble. Some of the slightly chaotic book noises. Subscribe and leave me a comment, feel free to do so. Just spur me on to make even more content for you and the stuff that you'd like to hear. But I hope you've enjoyed this. And now I'm going to go and get myself a brew. I hope everyone has a nice relaxing night. I hope everyone has a lovely weekend as well. And stay tuned for a 5-minute ASMR. video. That'll be up in a while.